In the last 10 years, more than 100,000 farmers have committed suicide. In a quarter of India's districts, cynicism and despair have pushed young people to take to the gun. To understand the roots of NREGA, we need to turn the clock back to yet another time of similar distress. Till the late 1920s, mainstream economics held firmly to the belief that chronic unemployment was a theoretical impossibility under capitalism. When India won independence, a clear role was visualized for the public sector to build infrastructure that would lay the foundations for the growth of the Indian economy. But the mid-1960s shook the foundations of this strategy. The country suffered catastrophic droughts, and it was realized that without developing our agrarian economy, we could never be secure. People continued to leave their villages, headed for the already overcrowded metros. Here they add to the growing numbers of those already standing in line, looking to be picked for work from day to day. Invariably, they end up living in subhuman conditions without basic civic amenities, worse off than their homes in the countryside. 6 decades of this kind of misery and a concerted struggle for the right to work finally led to the promulgation of the National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. All registered workers get job cards. These cards record the precise number of days of work and wages received by a family. They are both a proof of entitlement and a means of ensuring transparency under the program.
आज अपन जैसे लिख के दे रहे हैं कि 6 तारीख को हम ये आवेदन कर रहे थे, इसमें लिखा हुआ है कि राष्ट्रीय ग्रामीण रोजगार गारंटी योजना के अंतर्गत काम के लिए आवेदन दे रहे हैं।
But it has to be admitted that on a nationwide canvas, these stories are still only few and far between.
हमारे गुरमुठी गांव में ये घेटानार पारा है, हम लोगों की कोई काम नहीं मिलता है। कोई बाहर जाकर काम करता है, कोई यह पत्थर तोड़ रहा है, कोई किसी के जाकर बनी मजदूरी कर रहा है। खूब मिलता है 20 रुपया हम लोगों का मजदूरी, खूब मिलता तो, नहीं तो वह 10 रुपया 15 रुपया।
हम लोग ये नाम तक नहीं जान रहे, चेहरा तक नहीं जान रहे कि कौन है रोजगार सहायक, कौन आएंगे हमको बताने की ये काम के लिए ऐसा आवेदन दो।
आधे आधे सुखाते, आधे आधे खा जाते भाई, हमें कहाँ मिलता मंजर को।
4 महीना से हम लोग रोड में काम किए, हाजिरी भरने का हमारा क्या जिम्मेदारी, जिम्मेदारी आपका है, नहीं भरा है हाजिरी, मेरा पैसा रुक गया। अब कहते हैं कि फिर काम होगा तो फिर तुमको भर दिया जाएगा। अरे भर दिया जाए तो मैं मर जाऊंगा तो साले पंडित लोग खाएंगे ना उसको।
इट इज आयरोनिक दैट ऑल्दो द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इज विलिंग टू इंक्रीज एलोकेशंस फॉर दीज कॉस्ट्स, स्टेट्स आर येट टू एम्प्लॉय सफिशिएंट स्टाफ विद नेसेसरी क्वालिफिकेशंस। एज अ रिजल्ट they are unable to spend even the current 4% provided under the program. It is clear that for its enormous potential to be realized, we need drastic reforms in NREGA implementation. There are also many instances of straightforward corruption.
Kapil Ram ki parivar ki ek mukhiya hai, Kapil Ram, ye 5 din ka mazdoori kiye hain is rozgar guarantee mein ke tahat, और दो अतिरिक्त नाम हैं, पूर्णिमा एवं कबिलास, जो इस रोजगार गारंटी में काम नहीं किए हैं। ऐसे मैंने 108 अतिरिक्त हैं, काम नहीं किया उसका। फर्जी पेमेंट है।
Even though these are serious problems that have plagued employment programs in India over many decades, the unique thing about NREGA is that solutions to overcome these difficulties are also built into the Act. The most important of these is the mandatory requirement of social audits. The best example of which comes from Andhra Pradesh. The social audit process in Andhra culminates in a public meeting at the Mandal headquarters. As a nation, we really have no alternative. If we do not take care of our rural areas, we will only compound the already very deep crisis facing urban India.